Now, I think we're ready to share this model with others, and you know, we showed how everything, you know, you could do that within a project, but you know, what you can also do is you can share this as a template,
right
within the start page itself. So
yeah,
you know, can we save this as a new template for others to use? Because this is pretty generic. It's just a controller and a plant, and we had the settings all set up the way we want them set up because we had to do some of that. I don't want to have to do that again. And maybe I don't want to have my colleagues have to do that.
If I have to do this presentation again, right, and I want to show a model, I might not want to do it, start with a blank model. I might just want to open up this model as a starting point and start building it from there.
Right.
So I, even for that purpose, I would just want to export this model as a template. And I can give this any name. Basically, you can call it as a standard template. And you can also save the file name. Anything you want, I'll just use the same name so that it is consistent. And then I can set this as the default model template. By setting that, what happens is every time I create a new Simulink model, this will become, this is not optional anymore, this would become the default starting point. So I export it. And what happens now is if I go back to MATLAB, and start typing Simulink, you'll first of all notice that an SLTX file gets created here in my current directory. And if I open the start page, it shows up under My Templates. If I added any description, that description would show up here in, you know, in my description. But I can then start creating new models. Like if I can just hit this, that would create a new model, which is a new model with which is untitled at this point. I can start working from here rather than building it from scratch using a blank.
And every time you click on the new model button there on the left, it's because it's now the default template.
It just,
it's just going to create, it's going to use that template every time you create it.
Yes. But if you really don't want to do that, I mean, don't you want to have it as a template, but maybe you don't want it to be a default, you can simply, you know, use blank model, just go and set as, default. You can choose any template to be a default template.
And you could tell which one's your default template just by that green
orange
check mark over there. Orange check mark
over there.
Okay. And one other thing, you know, you pointed out that your template was saved, you know, just in the same directory. But I would imagine that if you're sharing this template with others,
you might want to.
Yeah, you want to put that on like a network drive that everybody has access to. And just make sure that that drive is on your MATLAB path.
I have seen other Simulink users create a project which just has templates, various templates. And share that project or reference that project. You can also do reference projects just like reference models. And they keep referencing all the templates in one project within their top level project. That way you have access to all templates in one place. But since we are here, I just want to point out you can access all your recent models, your recent projects. If you have a project you want to add to source control or retrieve from source control, you can do it straight from this page.
There's also examples
That
you can open up from the start page. So if you don't want to open up a blank model, or the templates are usually pretty basic. They're not full-on examples of how to use Simulink. So this tab is great. It has a number of nice examples.
Nice applications. Like this one, it shows a complete control plant model for fuel. Fault-tolerant fuel control system. There is a good documentation you can read. When you hit learn more, it takes you to the documentation. A lot of information of what this model does. But you can simply open up the example 2, which opens up the Simulink model, which has access to all the way this system is set up. It has a controller, it has a plant, and it has various signals coming in.
It also has a dashboard in here now. So
this
Yeah, this is essentially like a front-end UI for the model. We showed one piece of this in the model that we're building, which was just the dashboard scope on the bottom. But if you run the simulation, this dashboard is actually connected to the pieces of the model.
Mm-hmm.
So you can control, for example, the engine speed and switch it from 300 to 700. All it's doing there is it's changing the value of a constant block from 300 to 700.
Right.
But instead of somebody having to go into the constant block, open up the dialog box, manually type in 300, 700, this is a much easier way to do that.
Yeah, one use case I can think of is the calibration engineers who might not want to mess up with some of the values within the Simulink model. Rather, they would just open up this and have a visual sense of how the model is behaving.
Yeah, or you just hand it off to anybody who, you want them to simulate your model, but they don't know about, all the inner workings of, how the model behaves. And this is just an easier way to access all that.
Yeah. So we have seen just one example, but this is a example, so I cannot save it. So I'll just leave it as it is. I don't want to mess with it. And you can access several such examples, and not just within Simulink, but all the products that you have access to with their license, you can just access it.